So yeah, guys, last question. Wrap it up. We're about to go live right now. But yeah, I got.
Okay, cool. Hold up.
Hey.
Let's go. Hey, y'all.
Real life, Bubba, no lie.
What's up, bro?
I'm good, bro. What's up with you?
Yo, wait. Now I don't even know if it's you talking or it's the song. Can
Come
you hear
on,
me?
I've been talking. Yeah, I can hear you. Can you hear me?
Yo.
What's going on now? What's going on?
I think it's a headset game.
Can you hear me?
Nah. Can you guys hear me on the stream? Everybody who's on the stream.
Can you hear me now?
Okay, I can hear you, but you're very soft. I got you, yes.
I'm not sure what's going on.
Glenn.
You sharp, or not?
I'm sharp. Glenn, good to have you, man.
Good to be here. Otherwise, shout out to everybody that's watching.
That's so dope, dude. Yeah, man. We have questions that need answers. A whole lot of answers.
I got you.
Okay, so obviously, you know, congratulations on your many successes. Hopefully, I'm sure you are one of the artists who are well set up during this horrible time, which is lockdown. But shout out to you dropping two Skeif. Talk me through, you know, the two-track EP drop. And yeah, where are we going with this? What's popping?
Yeah, man. I mean, I felt like making music, first of all. Well, I've been making music. I felt like putting something out just generally to kind of at least, you know, uplift some spirits, you know, change the ship. So that people can get to sort of, you know, be in better spirit and think positively, at least, guy one. That's why I even called it to escape, because I'm a gentle. You know, you can't just go out there and buy cigarettes. So I'm like, yeah. I think you know, to escape, your number, you know? Yeah, that's really what it is. And also just, I mean, the one joint is very Kwesta-like, you know? It's very K1, got the Mzonkonko Kwesta shit. And the other joint is very, you know, I don't know, it's different from that. I don't know what to call that, you know. I just heard a dope beat and I was like, yeah.
Flex Nyana.
So I hit up Riky, who's definitely one of the gods of the source. You know, yeah. So and he jumped on the joint and murdered the shit out of it. So yeah, that was pretty much it. I wanted to give you guys two different sides. I'm corner bloggy, she was a corner Netflix.
Yeah, I know. Yeah. Definitely felt the finesse. Why did you decide to have someone jump, someone like Riky jump on the joint? Obviously, you guys speaking a lot about having, you know, your foot on the game's neck. Does that have anything to do with how consistent you guys have been in the game, always being on the charts? Always being a topic of conversation.
Yeah, definitely. It's really just a mixture of all these things that we've been doing throughout the years. I mean, we've been in this game for quite a bit, you know, and to be able to do something this consistently and for this long is crazy, you know. One of the things that we got their necks on. I mean, Ulrich's got the fashion thing going on also. He's got his foot on their necks there, you know. So we just really just, you know, just saying, hey man, this is what we do and part of the culture and how we've influenced it, you know, and how we played a part in how big it is or how influential it is, and also how it's played a part on us, you know. So we're really just talking about that. And Ulrich was a natural I made the song, and then it had the one verse in the hook, and I kept playing it, and I could hear him. I swear I could hear that verse before you even spit it, you know. I'm like, oh yeah, Ulrich, you know. So I sent it to him, and he played the same way, and he hopped on, and you know, it's the finesse, and that's how it was born.
Yeah, dude. Everybody on the stream, make sure you download to Skeif right now. Yeah. I wanna get into a little bit about uNjandini.
I think for me personally, growing up, I always felt like uNjandini, like mebakthuka, yabo.
But now that I'm hearing it on the toy, and I'm actually like, I'm actually covering like the description of what it means.
Can you just explain to the people what the word uNjandini actually means?
Yeah, uNjandini is like a low life of thoughts, you know. It's like Joe Busho, you know, movies on uNjandini, you know. And really my take on things is pretty much the same approach I did with, if you take Ngud, right? A lot of people who's Ngud, you know, it was looked down upon to a certain extent. I'm opposing Ngud, this, that and the third, you know, and I took that and flipped it over. Same thing with uNjandini, you know. I'm like, as it's really just about taking these titles that mean something negative and flipping them around to be something celebrated, you know, and saying, uNjandini, you know, is now out here just, you know, doing best. So it's a flip on the negative and turning it into positive.
That's really dope. But do you see
the amount of influence that you have for people to
look down on Ngud and all of a sudden hold Ngud with pride? Like, if I had Ngud right now, I would be so happy, bro.
You'd be, you'd be all up in there. Yeah, man. I mean, it's dope. It's dope that people gravitate towards these things and make them. I mean, as much as I can say I'm influential, people allow themselves to be influenced by something that they fuck with, you know. So it's great that people have allowed themselves to get influenced by the shit that I do, and they feel it's good enough to influence them. So shout out to the people. I mean, the influence is there because they open the doors for it, you know.
Yeah, that's hella dope. Yeah.
I want to ask you a personal question. Why do you think that you are an artist that raps in vernac mostly? You know, you're known for your Kasi rap, but at the same time, you're able to attract international and global. Why do you think that is for you as Kwesta? Because we've got so many artists that rap in English and just stick to that lane, but you don't see them on an international level. There's no international affiliation. So what do you think is so special about you and your sound that, you know, obviously makes these people gravitate towards you?
I think it brings about a sense of curiosity on their side, you know. They're like, what the fuck? What is that? Sounds dope, but what is he saying, you know? So there's a certain thing of we don't know this, but we fuck with it, you know. We're not sure what it is, hey, Mara Zatwala, you know. So the originality, you know, it'd be weird to kind of, it's difficult to kind of try and find something special in things that you always hear. I mean, if I try to sound like, say a Rick Ross, you know, then what, why would a Rick Ross even want to be on a joint with me, you know? Because well, he's trying to do what I'm doing, you know what I mean? So this to them is different, and this to me is a natural thing, you know. To me, it's not even something I put on, it's just what comes out when I rap sometimes, you know. And that's the influence Yelugishi and also, you know, some Burp Life, but you know, it's all authentically South African. So, and that's why it sounds like it sounds, and that's why it sparks interest even abroad, because as much as it's foreign, it sparks interest and curiosity, which, but it's so good, you know. It's foreign, but it's so good. I really mess with it, and I think that's it, man. It's just about us taking our culture out there to the rest of the world. Sibabonise, you know, which is Sinjani, from Elukshin to Mablazin, whatever the case is, and just wear that on our sleeves and just show them what we're about, and they seem to take more input when you do that than try copy what they do.
I hear that. That's really dope.
How was Rick Ross's reaction,
you know, to you taking him to this guy,
see, and all of those things? Like, how was that for him?
Crazy enough, it was actually really smooth. I mean, it took a bit of time with regards to he had just landed and things like that when we were shooting the video. Young God.
Yeah.
So when we were shooting the video, he literally had just landed, so we needed to rent Nyana, but he was all for the idea, you know. I think more than anything, in my head, thing is coward, like, shit, I wonder if this guy's gonna wanna do this thing or even participate. Because in my head, I'm starting to think of him, I'm thinking of him as Rick Ross, you know.
Yeah.
I didn't align myself with the people. he's a you know, see it through whatever he's committed to. You know? So that was a good thing. At least the outer shop, you know, he knows that the art is the art and we gotta see it through. You know? So it was pretty. It wasn't hard to get him to go to the hood. I think Nile Abuya Kon Abuya Makazan. You know, so it wasn't. It was obviously a different. It's obviously a different type of hood, but I'm a logish to Japan. I think so. He was very comfortable. You know?
Yeah, you know, what do you think matters more? Like hood fame, ukuthi kasla kulik accent, likunqanywe, or do you want like?
Yo. I don't know if it's you or me. I could barely hear you there.
Okay, can you hear me now?
Yeah, there we are. You're back.
Okay. I was saying yeah. That. So for you personally, imagine if K1 wasn't like one of the best.
Yeah, sure.
Be for you if you had global fame versus what's more valuable to you and why?
Yo. I mean, Angaz Noma is just, I don't know the answer to that generically, but
yeah.
I mean, for me, it's I don't know. I wouldn't want to do it without the guys, you know, without the KY. You know? I think I'd want the acceptance and love first before I go get it anywhere else. I'm told because if, you know, na yung kid, my bangs off, you know what I mean? It's like these people know me, I am them. You know, so if I'm on Fateli, then anything I end, grand, I represent. You know what I mean? That means I'm representing Ntandangayo if I'm on Fateli. You know, so first I gotta work on that. I gotta work on Tandolo Sekas, Tandolo Sendin, Tandolo Sejardin. You know, before I even go out and say, yo, I am this, because I need to embrace Langpumakon and Ayongkin. So for me, it's hood love first, and then take over the world, bro. You know.
Thanks. Take over the world with your hood on your back.
Right?
Yeah.
All right. So, what is Kwesta doing during quarantine? Like, how are you keeping busy? Have you been indoors? You know, do you have any advice for people? Because, you know, we're itching to get our asses up out of this house.
Yeah, I think it's that mind state. I will live a mind state here, itching to get out. It's like, in my head, I just feel like is my little bit to try and help. Young toilet.
Yeah.
It's not even so. I don't think of it as like yo, I'm set jail and I'm like, aye man, yes, he's and you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So the spirits in that case are never really very low, you know. So but yeah. I mean sometimes it hits you. Dang, I need to see people, you know. But holistically in the bigger picture of things, in the bigger scheme, you're like, aye man. But I'm seeing as you know, so I've just been chilling. I've been indoors, you know, as I should, and as I encourage Onkumu to teach you that I did. And I come here in the studio and lay down these ideas that come to me, you know. Sometimes I won't know about Pizgapul, Mustava Mouspana Grand, and told our Tolis Katsog in the studio, our Tolis Katsog, so we lock it down the idea. If you use a Kuluman, you know. So right now, everything that shoots into my head, yeah, record. Young Kintenge, yeah, say,
yeah.
So that's a plus, you know. And then otherwise, I'll connect and, you know, Plomanumde. You know, we just chill and we try and, you know, make the best in the situation, you know? But we're trying to not even think of it as a situation. It's just you know, we're trying to normalize it, you
know? Yeah, because I can imagine on a normal day-to-day basis or weekly basis, you're gigging, you're in and out of the house. It's very rare for this cardi so go mentally for 2 weeks now.
Yeah,
it's
hard. This is what I've been saying, Uti. As you know, you know, as I'm saying this to Mama, like, I'm like, you know, it's different, but you know, great. I mean, either way, it's just that via Ispanye, you know, inshallah, put Ispanazico and that Spanye, you know, and you miss going out there and performing and doing things, you know, so that hits. But generally, the being indoors is really the type of person I am. Generally, manga spanning sense. So it's bad because I was funny, but Ugba Senzi is not a new thing. It's not a foreign concept.
Yeah, and that actually leads me up to my follow-up question is that right now it's a very difficult time for people in the entertainment industry, right? So what's your advice for people in the entertainment industry to try and capitalize on this time and be able to monetize at the same time? Like, what alternatives
can we create for ourselves as artists, musicians, DJs, rappers?
Yeah, I mean, we have these platforms like Let's Ring Aguyo, you know, Insta Live and things like that. This is where we can really focus in, and this is where it matters the most, you know.
Yeah.
Because a lot of the time we use these platforms with Tink Bonis and Paye, Tink Bonis and Nani, Tink Bonis in it. Now it's actually time to actually use it for some content and for renewal and for appeal, you know. So I think people need to just sort of redirect their energies back into these platforms, but obviously now more content based, more content that they can use, more content that they can sell, you know, and then try. I mean, because abantu mhlampabana inyu at that point ngoba basband, you know, at this moment, so maybe try align yourself with some brands, you know, that are also looking to market something, that are looking to use your numbers and your influence, you know, so you align yourself with a bit of those Uguze, you know, ibhola lirole, because you're not selling
tickets.
Yeah. So manje, it's also very important to how you've been using these platforms. You know? If you've been an asshole of sorts in all these platforms and really ngatande, really your flex up, you know, and now you gotta use it for good. Ish bunzi manyana, you know. So because manje sekumele uSpanisa for Uvaiza, you know, it's going to be hard to change and flip it over into something positive. But I guess it's a lesson for the future. Again, uSpanisa lama platform for Uflex and to expand.
So I went to the studio, Magic. When can we expect? Well, what can we expect for this year? Can we expect an album? Who are you working with? You know, what's poppy?
I mean, vele album be going to be Spanish, you know, pretty much done with that, you know, guys, you know. Into buye shama Kev Paul nan yo lento lockdown the COVID, yabo ukuthi how do we release, when do we release, and how do we promote, and how do I, you know, all those things I'm still trying to figure out. But generally musically I'm done, you know, and music will drop, you know, whether it's going to be album music or not, ngisa figure out the situation near COVID.
Yeah.
You know, But while we're here, I mean, I'm going to drop a content. And then eventually, I'm going to figure out into and then I can go say, as in the album. You know what I mean?
Yeah. So maybe you're waiting for the right time, basically. It's perfect timing type shit.
Just waiting to figure it out. If we are to open Monday, what's next? Right after saying the album is out, what do I do? How do I promote? How do I, you know? And I also got a, and I'm figuring this online stuff out properly, you know, because I won't lie to you. When life was normal, I wasn't really on these platforms so much, except just to push the message. Okay. I was only just pushing the message, you know. So now I'm trying to figure out the behavior of all the people that use these platforms and things, so I can find the right place at the right time to and the right way to push whatever it is that I do.
Okay, some questions from the live stream, Nick. Do you think of the SA drill?
What do I think of SA drill? Let me tell you the truth. I don't even know the difference, right? Between drill, trap, rap. Like it to me, it's if a beat sounds dope, I'm jumping on it. I heard someone say The Finesse sounds like a drill joint, you know, and I'm like, oh, okay.
Yeah, it does. It actually does.
It wasn't. That was not my thing. In my head, I wasn't like, yo, let me make a drill like joint, you know. I mean, literally, how the beat was made. That day, I phoned and I recorded a voice note. Yeah. The melody of the beat, you know, how the beat should go. Dun, 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 dun. And I sent it to Gobi, you know, who ended up, I mean, I sent him that voice note and when the beat came back, it sounded like that. So in my head, I wasn't going, yo, I want to make a drill beat. I just sang a melody, sent it, the beat came back, I loved it, and I rapped, you know. So, me, if it feels right and it feels good, I'm rapping on it. That's just the type of the time. Is it?
Yeah, I know. I hear you. Sorry about that, Nick.
Yeah.
Okay, so I want to know, you work with Makwa a lot. Like, I think Makwa is sort of like attached to his, everybody knows him, you know, for working with you mostly. And I want to know, like, why do you work with producers like Makwa?
I mean, he's talented. I mean, the primary thing is his ability, you know. That's what I gravitated towards first, you know. And then and then eventually his love for the music, you know, and the creativity, and also the fact that, I mean, he made almost half of Dakar 2, you know, and while we were making that, we still made music even when that was done, and we kind of finessed and found a way to create a sound that pretty much only he and I can make, you know. At least a lot we can all try, but it's more natural and more effortless when it's just he and I, and that's just something our energies create together, and that's very rare. That's a very rare thing to find, you know. You work with the most talented producer and then you put him with the most talented rapper, but you're gonna find something, you know. And we have that, and that's a great thing, you know. He's literally shaped and found, and together with me found the Kwesta way of rapping, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
That Mzonkonko shit is really just some shit that we came up with after obviously working on a lot of other things, you know. So it's a natural, I work with him because it's a natural thing to do. It would feel wrong if I did. It's easy. It's natural. I don't even make a decision about it. It just, you know, I wake up and just think, yo, what did Makwa say? You know, it just happened.
That's really, really dope. That's really dope. That's really dope, Kwesta. Like, yo, shit, man. That's crazy, man. It's so good to talk to you. Last time we spoke to you was actually at the Telkom. There was an event in town. I think it was at... Telkom was doing something and you were like the ambassador. That was the last time we as Hip Hop 411 spoke to you. Yeah. I don't know if you remember that, do you?
I do. In Jersey, I remember, actually. I just forgot where exactly it was, but you can go there.
It's Randlords.
It's in Randlords, yeah.
So with that being said, like, is there any brands that you're going to be collaborating with, you know, going forward? Are you still with Telkom? Like, what's popping?
I mean, I'm not with Telkom. That contract, we had like a two contracts thing. We did the one for 6 months and another one for 6 months, so it was 1 year of two contracts, and that was over. And I mean, right now I've just been aligning myself, not too much as a long-term ambassador of things, but, you know, as per campaign and per thing that we're doing, per specific project, you know. I just did something cool with DJ Missin, you know, when we're doing the whole Smooth Sessions on Saturdays. I was hosting, well, people were performing in their own cribs and people could stream live, and also the Rapiverse competition that we did with Jameson also, you know, where we pretty much just, I pretty much made a song and left it halfway and left some space open for any rapper that feels like they can rap to just rap and have a joint together. And eventually there'll be a winner, which is the competition actually just closed on Sunday. And now it's just me listening back to everything that was uploaded by everybody, you know, which is quite a shitload. So it's going to take me some time. There's some fire. I won't lie to you. When I first started listening, I was like, I'm sure bazongkhinya abaningi and this, that, and the third, you know. Bazongithayela awuthi nje ifuna ukurapa nje. There's actually some real fire there. There's some actual talent out there, you know. So yeah, we're gonna announce the winner of that real soon, you know. And it was just something that I aligned with easily. It didn't even have too much to do with the fact that it was Jameson, but shout out to them for doing that. It was just the fact that it meant I could collaborate with people. That's just my shit, bro. I collaborate. That's just what I do. So it was easier to align with shit like that.
Are you looking to sign anybody to Rap Life? You know, right? Like coming.
Well, right now, not right now. I won't lie. You know, as time goes, maybe, you know, so add into the roster. But right now, not at the current moment, you know. But obviously, I'm this does not mean I'll shut down any door for anybody that I think is talented, you know. It's just that right now I'm consciously doing it. I'm not consciously saying I want to sign an artist. If I stumble upon something and I feel like I can help, then I'll obviously do it. But it's not in my immediate plans right now.
I just want to pick up you real quick for, you know, believing in like young upcoming artists, because like I think for the period of like 2018 and 2019, you were jumping on like upcoming artists' joints, which is very rare. Yeah. So hard to, like, you know, get a co-sign from a Kwesta or an AKA. I mean,
Yeah, yeah. It's because I understand the struggle of that, you know. I mean, I'll buzz to back to the TV or at the show when you are far back and all that shit, you know. So, and this was cut to you, I'm dope, you know. So I really just gave a chance to whoever I thought was dope, and I just said, yeah, I'm going to jump on the joint for whatever. And they even own those masters. I don't even want anything from that, you know. It's not even based on money or anything. It's just, you know, there's the artist I pick and I just go, yo, bro, here's a verse. That's it. Whatever you do with it, it's on you, you know. But there you go. You own the song. You own everything. Because I understand, yo, shit, inzima writing, you know. And sometimes you'll meet these people that are your idols. And, you know, sometimes I'm an SO. Sometimes they don't want to give you the time of day. And sometimes they're just too busy, bro. You know, so it's just the truth. Sometimes they're just too busy doing other shit. And I just wanted to kind of make time for that. Go, as in, nothing bigger than my cheetah, like, not however, like, yeah.
You know, we had a chat with the youngster in Cape Town, and he was telling us that before we actually popped off, he actually did like 32 mixtapes.
Yeah, you know? Youngster. When I first heard of Youngster, I think he was on his 25th mixtape.
Imagine.
The one that I heard for the first time was his 25th. That was crazy. So imagine the amount of listening back I had to go through. You know, I'm like, who's this guy? And I had to go get 25 mixtapes, you know, to be able to understand fully what was going on. So he's like, he really locks in when he locks in. You know? He doesn't play it.
So basically what I want to ask you is, for you, how long did it take you to fully like have like a footprint in the game? Like, how many years did it take? Or how long?
I mean, before I took my, eventually I decided to take to make like a demo at some point. I'd been rapping for about 2-3 years, you know, to tell you the truth. I'd been rapping for about 2-3 years maybe let's say 4 years, just to be safe. You know, I've been rapping for about 4 years, and then I had so many songs, and I just decided to pick some and put that in a demo and go to Slicker and Smacks, you know. And when I went to Slicker and Smacks, obviously they said, we're not looking to sign right now. But as soon as they heard, they like, we can't ignore this. And then they called. So it was about 3 or 4 years before that. I had been rapping for about 3 or 4 years before I took the demo to them. And as soon as they heard the shit, and they're like, yeah, no, as in, we tried to ignore it, we can't ignore it. So I was like, sorry. And that's how shit started. And this was like, I don't know, 2006,
2007.
Yeah.
That's amazing, Joe. Yo, because it takes 10 years deep for niggas to just get a hit song in, you know?
I mean, well, for me, to get the hit song and get it moving took time. I mean, the fact that being Spanish and I was big didn't mean that I was it. I was the shit.
Yeah.
You know? It meant I still had to work, you know, and I think only in 2012, this is now 2007 is when I got on, and in 2012 is when people really start, when I dropped Boom Shakalaka with X, that's when the conversations really started to change, you know. That's when the conversations really started to change, and then there was a song like Do Like I Do and all the features and shit, and then we dropped the album. Then it just kept going, and then it just kept going, you know. So yeah, also after getting signed, it took me also about 5-6 years after that, you know, just rapping, just being the guy.
Yo, Joe, last year was such a great year for you.
I've been blessed with quite a few of those, and it's been quite dope, though. And I like the fact that my career went like this, you know.
Yeah.
It didn't just hit the top, you know. Like, people feel like they've seen the growth and then the dip and then the growth back, you know. I like all that shit because it kind of, it thickens your skin and also gives you a lot of experience in the game. You kind of appreciate a lot of shit more.
Yeah, no, I think one of those Gemini and Tweezy battles are in order. Yo, we need to hear your hits.
Yeah,
actually, now...
They actually called me about it. Yeah, they called me about it. To say as soon as something, and then I because when I was rooting, so drop up uNjandini, and I was like, yo, just hold on a bit. Let me just get done with this thing that I'm doing, and then the push, and then. So for my next week, mailing Mbappele back. Me to say, yeah, remember that convo. Let's continue. You know.
But
something I'd be. I'd be willing to be a part of, definitely.
I'm Elubangeni, it's a classic. That shit is fire. Yeah. Like, for just SA hip hop in general.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
Yeah, I never forget.
All right, Mr. Dakar, thank you so much for chatting to me. Hopefully, we're going to see you in the streets soon. You know,
as soon as we're back in the streets, I'm out there. You know what I mean? We'll catch each other on that side. But shout out for this convo. Really refreshing. Not appreciate fact, it. Dog.
Make sure everybody on this live stream, go get to Skeif B and The Finesse.
Yeah, right now, everywhere. Njandini and The Finesse with Rick. To Skeezers. Sick.
All right, cool, man. Have a great evening. Stay well.
You too, man. Stay well, stay safe, stay indoor.
You know what it is. Yo, shout out to everybody who's on the stream. Yeah, man. It's your girl, Mbli the Jerk. Go follow me on all platforms.